Blackstone Audio presents Defiance, The Bielski Partisans, by Nechama Tec. Read by Stefan Rudnicki. To the memory of Arya Gelblum. Author's Preface. My research about the Nazi annihilation of European Jews alerted me to a serious omission and an equally serious distortion. The omission is the conspicuous silence about Jews who, while themselves threatened by death, were saving others. The distortion is the common description of European Jews as victims who went passively to their death. This book is based on evidence that corrects both. It shows that under conditions of human degradation and suffering, Jews were determined to survive. They refused to become passive victims. Propelled by the desire for freedom, risking death, many escaped from the ghettos to the countryside and forests of wartime Western Bielorussia. There, some of them created a Jewish partisan unit, the Bielski Partisan Detachment, that gave protection to all Jewish fugitives. Assuming the dual role of rebels and rescuers, this group grew into a forest community of more than 1,200 that distinguished itself as the most massive rescue operation of Jews by Jews. The history of this community, composed of fighters, rescuers, children, older men and women, fits into my past research about personal courage, resistance, refusal to accept evil, and mutual help. It is also tied to my personal history, that of a hidden child. I belong to a small minority of Polish Jews who survived World War II by staying illegally in the forbidden Christian world. For 3 years, protected by Christian Poles, I lived under an assumed name, pretending to be Catholic. At the end of the war, I resumed my former identity, determined to put this past behind me, and shied away from all wartime memories. For some unexplained reason, by 1975, these childhood experiences began to demand attention. When these demands turned into a compelling force, I decided to revisit my past by writing an autobiography. As I was recapturing my wartime life, the same few questions kept recurring. What was it like for other Jews who tried to pass as Christians? What made some Poles defy all the dangers and risk their lives for Jews, who traditionally were regarded as Christ killers, and who, for many still unexplained reasons, were blamed for every conceivable ill? Who were these rescuers? Who were the Jews who benefited from this protection? Later, with my autobiography behind me, eager to find answers to these questions, I embarked on research that examined two groups: the rescuers and the rescued. I had assumed that each group, the Polish rescuers and the Jewish survivors, would react in different ways to their respective circumstances. This study took me to several archival collections. At one, the Jewish Historical Institute in Warsaw, I came upon the story of Oswald Rufeisen. A Jewish youth of 17 when World War II began, he survived by pretending to be half German and half Polish. He became an interpreter and a secretary in a German gendarmerie in Western Bielorussia, wore a Nazi uniform, and in this capacity, while risking his life, saved hundreds of Christians and Jews. I was intrigued by Oswald Rufeisen, not only because of his unusual life, but also because I was not sure how to classify him. His case presented me with a dilemma. Was he a rescuer or a survivor? In the end, I classified him as a survivor and concentrated on the help he received while passing as a non-Jew. After I finished writing about Polish rescuers and Jewish survivors, I made Oswald Rufeisen's story the focus of my next book. Only after I concentrated on writing about him did I become aware that some Jewish survivors I had written about, although in less dramatic ways, had also helped others. Why had I overlooked their acts of altruism? Was my insensitivity to Jews as rescuers based on the assumption that one could not simultaneously be a victim and a rescuer? Did I think that as the main targets of Nazi persecution...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.